What's going on, guys? Fortminor back at it again in here for another video for you guys for today. And then you're going to give my thoughts on the draft as well as a supplemental draft too as well. And, you know, giving my thoughts on who went where and that, you know, I might be able to get through everyone. We'll have to wait and see. If not, I will give my thoughts in the way or just, you know, pretty much the results down below. You guys can give your own thoughts as well as with the end of the video, so you can continue the discussion down in the comment box. But what brand I'm going to start with, and that is SmackDown. And SmackDown did pretty well this year. I was pretty happy about that. The only thing I didn't like with John Cena, originally he was drafted to SmackDown, but towards the end of the show, he was drafted back to Raw with the last draft, so I didn't really care for that too much. It was like, what the hell was going on with that? So that made no sense at all, to have, you know, John Cena drafted and redrafted back to Raw. So that's the only thing really I didn't like too much. But yeah, John Cena, yes, is still on Raw, not on SmackDown. So that's it with that when it comes to John Cena anyway. First guy I got here, and that is Randy Orton. He was one of the major picks that went to SmackDown, which I, you know, was having him on my predictions to go to SmackDown, so which is a good thing. Give SmackDown to have, you know, some star power going into, you know, Friday nights. And Randy Orton, I think that's a good fit for him. So you know, I think he'll do good there and have some good matches and do you know, good there. So that's it when it comes to Randy Orton. So that's a good thing on that. Alright, next guy I got here, and that is Mark Henry. It appears that he's going to be a heel now on SmackDown. We saw that when he basically turned his backs on John Cena and Christian, walking out of the six-man tag, and basically, that's basically it what happened with Mark Henry. So it looks like he's going to be a heel, so it's going to be kind of interesting. But yeah, that's it when it comes to Mark Henry on that note. Next guy I got here is definitely becoming one of my favorites, and that is Sin Cara. That's why he will be now on SmackDown. I think that's a good home for him, and a good way to, you know, start up his career, maybe down the line, towards the end of the year for the next draft. He'll go over to Monday Night Raw or something like that, but, you know, we'll have to wait and see. But SmackDown, I think, is a good fit for him, so I expect good things out of his career for SmackDown, and that's a good home for him. Next guy I got here, and that is Daniel Bryan, another one of my favorites, so I am happy that Daniel Bryan was able to go to SmackDown during the supplementary draft, which was yesterday. And, you know, with the draft yesterday, it took, like, a long time. It almost seemed like all day with the draft, too, so I don't know if that's the first time that ever happened. I don't remember it taking that long, but that's what really happened with that. It lasted a couple hours, but hey, that's it with that. But Daniel Bryan, I was happy he, you know, was able to get drafted from yesterday. And, you know, with that being said, I think you have, you know, a better chance with SmackDown and have some good matches. There are a couple of guys that went from Raw to SmackDown that he could work with there and have maybe a feud with. So that could, you know, also work. Maybe win a couple of championships there as well. And the only thing he really did on Raw was win the United States Championship and become a part of the original Nexus. So, you know, hopefully Daniel Bryan will get lost in the shuffle for SmackDown. Next guy, nothing really too much to say. Great khali, was able to get drafted, so it's whatever with that. Next guy, or guys I should say, is Jimmy and Jey Uso. Now, during the draft yesterday, they were split up a little bit when one of the Usos went to SmackDown, but the following Uso was able to get drafted as well, so the Usos are now back together on SmackDown. So I guess this will be, you know, good for them, but we'll have to wait and see. Next guy I got here is William Regal. Now with William Regal, I think this is a good move for him. Maybe he'll get on TV more and do some matches, and especially with Daniel Bryan, which is one of the guys I was going to get into too. I think Daniel Bryan versus William Regal on SmackDown will be a good match to see. I believe we did get to see a little bit of that on the Royal Rumble, or just a little preview, so maybe we'll have a program with Daniel Bryan and William Regal, who knows. But hey, that's a good idea, and I think that would be a good match. Alright, next guy I got here, and that is Ted DiBiase, also getting drafted from Raw to SmackDown. Now, he didn't really do so well on Raw. Now that he's basically on the same show with Cody Rhodes, maybe they'll be tonight. We'll have to wait and see where that goes. Maybe Ted DiBiase, this will be his next best thing for him, and maybe do better here. Do better with his character, and, maybe win a couple of championships here and there, and we'll have to wait and see what comes with Ted DiBiase, but, hopefully this will be the next best bet for him. Next guy I got here, and that is Yoshi Tatsu, also coming in from Raw to SmackDown. I guess this is a good move for him, so I think he'll do pretty well there, so that's it when it comes to Yoshi Tatsu. Next guy I got here, and that is Tyson Kidd coming over from Raw to SmackDown. Like William Regal, I think he will have a good match with Daniel Bryan. We did get to see that in the tag team match not too long ago, and they worked really well. So with them going into a singles match, I think that we're going to tag team match again. That would be actually really good to see. Whether that's going to be on the pay-per-view or just for SmackDown in general, I think that would be a good match for them. And maybe this we'll get to see a more serious side still from Tyson Kidd, and maybe have him be used more so after we see. Another guy I got here, which kind of came to a surprise and was also drafted, and that is, yes, Alex Riley, being away from The Miz now, and definitely in the way, now being on his own on SmackDown. So it's going to be really interesting to see what's going to come of Alex Riley now that he's on his own, as well as The Miz. So maybe he'll do something different now, and The Miz can show that he doesn't need Alex Riley to, help him retain the WWE title and can be on his own and be pretty much a legit champion. So, so that's going to be really interesting in the next couple of weeks to see where it's going to go. So that's it when it comes to Alex Riley. Next guy, which kind of came to a surprise, with this, and I kind of expected him to go there too as well, but not with the way and how it happened. Wade Barrett wasn't able to get drafted, but Sheamus was able to get drafted too from Raw to SmackDown. So not only does SmackDown have Sheamus and Wade Barrett, but they also have two championships, Intercontinental and U.S. Championship. So I'm not sure if they're going to unify the championships. That would be kind of, weird. I don't know if I really want to see that or not. It's going to be interesting to see how that's going to turn out in the next couple of weeks. Maybe one of the championships will go back to Raw, at least I'm hoping. Maybe we'll see that by the Extreme Rules pay-per-view. So, also, we'll probably get to talk to them about that in the Ustream show. That's why me and Gunnar SND will be going back live on his channel, this Sunday for the Extreme Rules pay-per-view. Preview show, so maybe we'll get to talk about that whole situation going on there. So that's basically it when it comes to that. Going with the Divas, not really talking about them too much. SmackDown earned three Divas here, and that is Alicia Fox, Natalya. I think that's pretty much it. Oh yeah, and Tamina too. And so they're able to be at SmackDown now, so that's a pretty cool move there. So that's it when it comes to Divas. Alright, so now we move on to Monday Night Raw, and coming over from SmackDown to Raw, and a guy I actually thought he was going to stay on SmackDown, and that is Alberto Del Rio. That's right, he was able to get drafted to during the regular draft on Monday. So, I guess, maybe Alberto Del Rio might win a championship there on Raw, continue his dominance in a way on Raw. So, it looks like he might have less of a chance of winning the world title, and Christian might have a higher chance of winning the world title this Sunday. So, again, we'll probably talk about that on the Extreme show as well, so stay tuned for that. Alright, next guy I got here, and that is Rey Mysterio, back over to Raw. He was in the draft in 2008, I believe, if I'm not mistaken. So Rey Mysterio is back on Raw, and Rey Mysterio and Sin Cara both being on separate shows. It would have been nice if they were both in the same brand and maybe have a feud or a tag team, but that's basically not going to happen now since they're on separate shows. So Rey Mysterio moving over, I guess that's good. So, you know, we have, you know, two different high flyers on, you know, different brands, so I guess that's good in a way. Next guy I got here, and that is Big Show. I thought he was going to stay on SmackDown, being the fact he is one half of unified tag team champions with Kane. So Kane wasn't able to get drafted, neither during the online drafts. So, you know, it's really whatever with that. He can basically go on both shows, so not really say too much with that. Next guy I actually predicted to go over to Raw, and that is Jack Swagger, also being drafted too, so in a way he can be with Michael Cole more often and maybe do better on Raw and maybe win a couple of championships here and there and do better with his character. So we'll have to wait and see, you know, during the couple of weeks and throughout the year what's going to become of Jack Swagger, so I think he'll do better there. Next guy I got here, JTG, nothing really to say there, but, you know, probably be there once in a while, I'm sure, so that's it when it comes to JTG and that one. Next guy I got here, and that is Drew McIntyre, is also being able to get drafted too, so, Drew McIntyre, I kind of predicted him that he was going to go, but we did get to see him on Raw there too as well. You know, this past week, so I thought he was going to actually understand SmackDown 2 a little bit, but we'll have to wait and see what happens with Drew Mac. The next guy I got here, and that's Curt Hawkins. Curt Hawkins, you know, I like this guy. I think he's a good wrestler, so maybe he'll be used more on Raw. Now, Zach Ryder sadly did not get traded to SmackDown, so maybe with this will be the reuniting of Zach Ryder and Curt Hawkins as a tag team, so I think that would be actually pretty cool to see. And, you know, we'll have to wait and see what happens with Curt Hawkins and Zack Ryder, so that's it with that. Next guy, Chris Masters, he was kind of getting a push on SmackDown, and now he's been drafted to Raw, so I don't know if it's going to affect him or not, but anyway, that's it with Chris Masters. Next guy, also going back to Raw, is Kolfi Kingston. I think that's a good move for Kolfi. Maybe he'll do better there and get into a couple of feuds instead of the same old ones over and over again. That's it when it comes to Kingston. Next guy, Tyler Rex. You know, this guy's actually pretty good. I think he'll probably be dominant over there. I think he'll do pretty well on that Raw. Maybe he'll get to be used on the show more often, so we'll have to wait and see. Next guy, I think that's basically it. Yeah, so that's it with the guys, and now we go into the Divas. Beth Phoenix and Kelly were the only Divas drafted from SmackDown to Raw, so that's basically it with the list here. But yeah, that about does it for this video. Let me know what you guys thought on the draft and supplemental draft as well. What you liked about it, what things you think should be different, what you liked about it. That about does it for this. Drop your comments down there below. Continue the discussion, and that about does it for this video. Also, I will see you guys this Sunday for the live stream show for Extreme Rules pay-per-view preview. So that about does it, like I said, and as always, I'll talk to you guys later on. Peace.